Hello students, we are on part 2, how to draw the molecular orbital diagrams. Molecular orbital diagrams of some other molecules now. So in the previous part of this video, we have done the filling of electrons in H2, HE2 and in case of Li2. Okay, so now we are moving with the filling of electrons in more than 8 case. Till now we have studied that for filling of the 8 electron, we need to fill 1s2. Then antibonding 1s2, followed with 2s2, and then antibonding 2s2. So the filling of the 8 electron always remains same whether we are talking about filling up to 14 electrons or more than 14 electrons. But now we are starting with filling of electrons up to 14 electrons. Okay, this is for the 8 electrons that we have done in the previous part. Now up to 14 electrons, what is followed is sigma 1s2, antibonding 1s2, sigma 2s2, antibonding 2s2. Now what happened when we are filling up to 14 electrons? The method followed is considering the degenerate orbitals also, that is 2px and 2py. So 2px and 2py are considered to be having the same energy. So we will fill pi 2px having energy equal to pi 2py. And when we will fill both the 2 electrons in these cases, then only we will move on to sigma 2p Z2. Although we are going to write the names that we can write pi antibonding 2px, pi antibonding 2py, pi antibonding 2pz, but up to filling of 14 electron, we require only up to sigma 2p Z2. Drawing of diagram requires the complete procedure, but while writing the configuration, we can write only up to sigma 2p Z2. So let us start with the filling of electrons in N2 case, that is nitrogen. We will follow all the rules, that is Abbau, the Hund's, Pauli's, all the rules have to be considered. In case of nitrogen, which is having 14 electrons, the filling takes place as the given above, following the same. Above we have filled up to 14 electrons. Now, after writing the configuration, but we have decided that we will draw the diagram. So drawing of diagram always takes place from the lower energy to the higher energy. So just have a look how the diagram is to be drawn. This is for sigma 1s2. Then labeling is very essential. Then we will draw for sigma 2s2 and its antibonding part. Remembering that the sides are known as the atomic orbital and the middle one is known as the molecular orbital. Then in case of P, the sides are Px, Py and Pz, all are having the equal energy. And similarly here, the other atomic orbital is also having Px, Py and Pz. But we must remember that 2Px and 2Py are having the equal energy and they are in the pi nature. Then sigma 2Pz, the higher one, pi antibonding 2Px, 2Py. And then the upper one, the last one, that is pi antibonding 2px and pi antibonding 2pz. So with the starting with the labeling part of it, we will draw it as sigma 1s2, sigma antibonding 1s2, we have to fill 14 electron, sigma 2s2, sigma antibonding 2s2. Then we will write pi 2px2, which is having the energy equal to pi 2p by 2 and 10 electrons have been filled. Now sigma 2p Z2. Although we will write the name of the above one also, that is pi antibonding 2px, pi antibonding 2py, both having equal energy, but none of the electron is there. Sigma antibonding 2p Z. So as soon as we will write the configuration and draw the things, we will start filling the electrons in it. So the electrons are 2 in each of the case, sigma antibonding, sigma 2s2, and then its antibonding part. Filling the atomic orbitals also, because the middle one is the molecular orbital and the side ones are the atomic orbitals. And a sign of energy which is going upward, showing that the energy is increasing from down to top. In the center, we have filled the 4 electrons, 2 from this atomic orbital and 2 from this. in the center of sigma 2p 2s2 and sigma antibonding 2s2, again there are four, and two in this case and two in the other case. Then in the above one, pi 2p x2, pi 2p y2 and sigma 2p z2, again there are total of six electrons. Okay, and three will be divided on the one side and three on the other. So these are the 2p. This is 2p also for the other nitrogen atom. And the lower one are 2s. And the lowest is 1s. So first we will write the configuration, as in case of N2 we have written for 14 electrons. Following the same, drawing the diagram, the other thing that we have to do is number of the first case, writing the configuration, drawing the diagram, then calculating number of bonding is greater than number of antibonding or not. So in case of 14 electron, the total is for bonding is 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. So bonding electrons are 10 and antibonding are 4. So it will be stable in nature. Now the B part. What is the bond order? We know that the bond order is number of bonding minus number of antibonding divided by 2. So number of bonding minus antibonding, 10 minus 4 by 2, that is, it comes out to be 3, and we know that nitrogen forms a triple bond with the other nitrogen atom. Now the third part. In the third part, we used to calculate the magnetic character. We find that all of them are having two electrons in the form of pair. So it is going to be diamagnetic in nature. So the main thing followed with the molecular orbital diagrams are, first we will write the configuration. Then we will write the, we can make the diagram finding the stability, bond order and diamagnetic character. Now other than this, there are also the questions in which we have to compare the N2 positive, N2, N2 negative. We can also compare the bond length, the bond order, their magnetic character also. So having a look of this type of question also. Now let us compare the certain species, such as we have to compare certain species as, for example, N2, N2 positive, N2 negative, and N2 2 negative. This type of questions are also very common. Then we have to calculate their bond order. So for bond order, we are supposed to write the configuration, or if you can calculate directly, must be remembering that how the configuration is followed. Up to 14 electron, it is pi 2 px2 equal to pi 2 py2. And then we will write the sigma 2 pz2. So when we will calculate the bond order for N2, it comes out to be 3. For N2 positive, it is 2.5. We know that the bond order can be in fraction. For N2 negative, again, it is 2.5. And for N2 2 negative, it is 2. Now the other thing, we have to calculate the stability. The stability is directly dependent on the number of bonding electrons, the number of antibonding electrons, the bond order. So the most stable case is N2. It is going to be most stable in nature. Then N2 positive and N2 negative are less stable. Both are having the similar bond order. And when we talk about N2 2 negative, it is going to be the least stable in nature among all of these. It is going to be least stable. Then this is the comparison about the stability. Then we come about the magnetic character. When we are talking about the magnetic character, we have to write the configuration and seeing whether all are having the power is 2 or even there is the presence of unpaired electron or not. So when we will compare the bond order in the magnetic character of N2, writing the configuration, we will find that N2 is diamagnetic in nature. N2 positive is going to be paramagnetic. N2 negative is also going to be paramagnetic in nature. And what about N2 2 negative? It is also going to be paramagnetic. So let us see how N2 2 negative is paramagnetic. N2 2 negative is equal to 16 electrons. N2 negative is equal to 15 electrons. N2 positive, that is equal to now 13 electrons. And what about N2? It is equal to 14 electrons. N2 2 negative is equal to 16, that is similar to the O2 one. Oxygen molecule is also having the 16 electrons. So when we will draw the O2 case, we will came to know about how it is going to be paramagnetic in nature. But the stability here is compared among N2 positive, N2 negative, and N2 2 negative. Now, if we compare the bond dissociation energies of these, so we have studied that bond dissociation energy is directly proportional to bond order. So the one which is having the higher bond order is going to have the high bond dissociation energy. So N2 greater than N2 plus is equal to N2 minus, because both are having the 2.5 number, and the least one is having the N2 2 negative. But the same work when is done for the bond length. So we know that the bond length is inversely related to bond order. Bond length is inversely related to bond order. So the one which is having the highest bond length is N2 2 negative. Then comes the case of N2 positive and N2 negative. Both will be same because the bond order is same. And the smallest bond length is going to be in the case of triple bond, that is N2. So it is not only the case that we are going to draw the diagram or finding the stability. The questions can be regarding the comparison also. Compare the bond order of all these species, compare the stability, compare the magnetic character, bond length, or bond dissociation energy. So the same pattern of diagram is to be followed in case of 12 electron, that is C2, 10 electron, that is B2 boron molecule, and 14 electron, that is N2, we have just done now. So now comes the case of O2. O2, that is the 16 electrons. So let us draw the diagram and compare this thing also. O2 is having a 16 electrons. And writing the configuration follows sigma 1s2, sigma antibonding 1s2. We can even draw the increasing and decreasing sign for the energies also. So sigma 1s2, sigma 2s2, followed with antibonding 2s2. Okay, but in case we have talked in the beginning also that in case of 16 electrons, 18 electron, and 20 electrons, sigma 2pz acquires the lower energy level. So sigma 2pz2, then comes the time of pi 2px2, which is going to having the equal energy as that of pi 2p, pi 2. Then comes the, there is no change in the antibonding case. It is again antibonding 2p, x, antibonding. This is a general representation, and in case of oxygen we will write only up to that time where the 16 electrons get completed. So till this 14 electrons have been completed, then pi antibonding 2px, pi antibonding 2py, we will write the complete is sigma antibonding 2pz. So students, you can see that there is no change in the energy of pi antibonding 2px, 2py, and 2pz. But there is a change in energy when we are talking about O2, F2, and Ne2. Sigma 2pz gets the lower energy as compared to the degenerate pi 2px and pi 2py. So what we are going to do for completing the 16 electrons, one we will give to pi antibonding 2px, and the other we will be giving to pi antibonding 2py. Because according to Hund's, if there are the degenerate orbitals, then we have to divide the electrons equally among both of these. So the configuration for O2 becomes sigma 1s2 antibonding 1s2, sigma 2s2 antibonding 2s2, sigma 2pz2, pi 2px2, which is having equal energy as pi 2py2, pi antibonding 2px1 equal to pi antibonding 2py1, and sigma antibonding 2pz0. Although I have written it, but there is no need because there is no electron present in it. So now comes the case of the next case we are talking about is drawing the diagram. So starting from the very lower energy part, the same is method is followed for, this is the atomic orbital for 1s, for again the same we will follow for 2s, then for 2s, is it okay? Now the same thing as we have done in the previous one. Then the third case is for drawing the 2pz. 2px, 2py, 2pz, the atomic orbitals are equal in both the cases. Then 2pz acquires the lower energy, sigma 2pz. Then comes the time of pi antibonding 2px and 2py. pi 2px and 2py, then antibonding 2px and 2py, and then the last case is of sigma antibonding 2pz. So what the difference we have seen here, that the pz has got the lower energy. In sigma 2pz, the energy is lower as compared to px and py. So we will write the configuration also. Sigma 1s2, antibonding 1s2, sigma 2s2, antibonding 2s2, then sigma 2pz2, then comes the time of pi 2px2, pi 2py2, then pi antibonding 2px1, pi antibonding 2py1, then sigma antibonding 2pz0. This is the case of oxygen, in which we have to fill accordingly. So now filling of the electrons takes place. It is like this, that we have 1s2, that filling of electron 2, again 2, total 4 in the center. So 2 on the sides of it, that is the atomic orbital part. Then center is the molecular orbital. Then it is for 1s, then 2s, sides atomic orbital 2s, sigma 2s2, sigma antibonding 2s2. So center is again 4, 2 on one side of the atomic orbital, 2 on the other atomic orbital. Now again the case here, 2pz2, 2px2, 2py2, 1 in pi antibonding 2px and 1 in pi antibonding 2py. So now we have to fill, now in the center there are total 8 electrons. We have to fill 4 on one side and 4 on the other side. So we can draw it like this, 1, 2, 3, and then 4. Again the same case, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And a line for energy showing that energy is increasing from down to top, that is lower energy to the higher energy. So first we have wrote the configuration, then draw the diagram. And now what we are supposed to do, we have to calculate the bond order, the stability, and the magnetic character. So first point, that is whether it is stable or not. So we will calculate the number of the bonding and the number of the antibonding electrons. So let us see how many bonding electrons are there. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 10 are the bonding electrons. NB is equal to 10. NAB is equal to, antibonding is equal to 6. So it is going to be stable in nature. The second part is the bond order. Bond order is equal to number of bonding minus number of antibonding divided by 2. That is, the bond order comes out to be 2. Double bond, and we know that oxygen is double bonded in nature, O2 molecule. Now the third case is the magnetic character. We, in the configuration, it is very well visible that pi antibonding 2px and pi antibonding 2py, both are having one electron. So even there is presence of 2 unpaired electron, we cannot say it is a pair. There are 2 unpaired electrons. So magnetic character is going to be paramagnetic in nature. So this is about how the oxygen has to be drawn. It is to be very well kept in mind that in case of 16, 18, 20, we have to keep sigma 2pz before pi 2px and pi 2py, but there is no change in energy of the antibonding one. So this is about O2. Now, another similar type of question that we have to do for the comparison of O2 as we have done for N2. Now, in the comparison of O2 part, O2 species will be given to us. We will write the species, that which species are given. Let us say that O2 positive, O2, O2 negative, and O2 negative. Let us suppose that these species are provided to us. Now the first case, we will write the bond order of all of these. Bond order, we will write the configuration. No need to draw the diagram. Writing the configuration can help us in calculating the bond order. The bond order of O2 positive comes out to be 2.5. It is 2. It is 1.5 and 1. When you will write the configuration, you can very well calculate the bond order here. Now comes the stability, which is going to be most stable in nature. So greater the bond order, greater the stability. So it is going to be most stable. Then in case of 2, it is less stable compared to 2.5. It is less stable. it is still less stable. And what about the one bond order? It is going to be the least stable among all of these. So comparison is done on the in terms of bond order. Now comes after the bond order, the magnetic character. Magnetic character, O2 positive, it is having 15 electrons. O2 is having 16, O2 negative is having 17, and O2 negative is going to have the 18 electrons. So 15 one must be one left here is, so it is paramagnetic in nature. Although it seems 16 electron will be a paired one, but as we have drawn the configuration for O2, we find that there is unpaired electron in 2px and 2py, pi antibonding 2px and pi antibonding 2py. So it is also going to be paramagnetic in nature. 17, a number which is also going to be paramagnetic in nature. And for 18, which is very well similar to fluorine, 18 electron case is similar to fluorine, which is a diamagnetic case. Because in that case, pi antibonding 2px as well as pi antibonding 2py, both are going to be having 2 electrons each. Then came the, this is the similarity part. And we have to compare now the bond order, the stability, the bond dissociation energy. We know that the bond dissociation energy is directly proportional to bond order. So the one which is going to have the higher bond order is going to be more having the dissociation energy. So in terms of bond dissociation energy, which is going to be having the highest, O2 positive greater than O2, greater than O2 negative, and greater than O2 negative. But when we are talking about the bond length, we know that the bond length and bond order are inversely related to each other. Higher the bond order, smaller is the bond length. So the bond dissociation and bond length are totally reverse of each other. So we will be also following the reverse trend. O2 negative, O2 negative, then O2 negative, O2, and then O2 positive. Such type of increasing and decreasing orders, arranging them, are all based on half marks, one marks question. So bond length of O2 negative is going to be the highest one. If we will draw the same pattern for F2, Ne2, we will find that Ne2 is having no existence because Ne is a noble gas. It don't require to make a bond with the other atoms also. So this is about how to draw the molecular orbital diagrams for the different species. So after this whole topic, you must be able to draw the molecular orbital diagrams of H2, He2, then Li2 and Be2, all based on 8 electrons. Then after that, comparison the 14 electron cases, that is B2, C2, and then N2. For more than 14, that is the 16, more than 14 electron case that you will be drawing, greater than 14 electron are O2, F2, and Ne2. Prepare these diagrams, their bond order, their paramagnetic character or diamagnetic, and also the comparison of the similar species also, as N2, N2 positive, N2 negative, O2, O2 positive, O2 negative, because these are very important in terms of increasing and decreasing trends. So after this video, we will be meeting in another one, that is the hydrogen bond. Till then, revise this topic. Goodbye.